Report, The Executive Summary, A Closer Look, Part 1, by Zachary Koppelman. Executive summaries, the second layer of report, are complex and multi-layered. Their purpose is to fully summarize report, highlighting the major points in a manner that allows your boss's boss to make an informed decision about a project. Because of this, carefully examining a sample executive summary can demonstrate how a short document can effectively fulfill an important role. We have been looking at four major needs to craft an efficient executive summary. 1. Directly and clearly state the purpose of the report. 2. Explain the procedures used to fulfill the purpose. 3. Logically present the results. 4. Directly and clearly state the conclusions. For this comparison, we will add two more universal points. Be concise and balanced. Use specific terms and details. Now we will compare two different sample executive summaries. To start, we will focus on the first point. Directly and clearly state the purpose of the report and the two universal points. Please be aware that this sample is from a specific course at Purdue University. Therefore, some of the terminology is geared directly at those students. First version. The objective of this project is to conduct an extensive study of the bicycle high-end accessory market and identify potential new product areas that show promise for future development. Second version. This report is a compilation of 4 weeks of research into the bicycle market. Our design team has been assigned the problem of designing a bicycle system that provides improved ride quality compared to a conventional bicycle. In order to prepare our team for the actual design of a new bicycle system, we completed extensive research into the world of bicycles and bicycle riders. The first version follows the first major need of an executive summary while following both of the universal needs. The project conducts research into high-end bicycle accessories to find potential marketable areas. In one 30-word sentence, the reader knows the entire focus of the project and has a couple of specific, concrete details needed to fully understand the project. The second version does not meet the first need or follow either of the universal needs. It eventually makes a point, but it is weak and vague. Design a bicycle system. Takes over twice as many words and 3 imprecise sentences to only suggest the purpose. The first version has a tight focus on what is being done and why. The second version has a broad, poorly defined focus. A poorly defined focus is a red flag to your readers. If the focus can't be narrowly defined, it is a good bet that the team working on the project doesn't really understand what they are doing. Never give your readers a reason to doubt your work. A poorly defined focus raises many concerns and doubts. Look carefully at the description used in each version. The first version uses specific descriptions. Bicycle high-end accessory market, potential new product areas that show promise for future development. Second version is far less specific. The bicycle market, a bicycle system that provides improved ride quality compared to a conventional bicycle. Bicycle high-end accessory market is more descriptive than bicycle market. Potential new product areas that show promise for future development is more descriptive than a bicycle system that provides improved ride quality compared to a conventional bicycle. A bicycle system and improved ride quality look and sound descriptive, but a bicycle system could be anything from an entirely new bicycle design to a refined seat. Improved ride quality also sounds specific, but it could mean using inner tube tires instead of solid rubber, or it could mean a highly sophisticated suspension system. Without a context, these statements are worthless. The difference is accomplished through using specific, concrete terms, moving rapidly through multiple steps without using long phrases to introduce concepts and ideas. Exactly what was researched, how it was researched, and why the research was needed is important. For an executive summary to work its best, it needs to create a clear image of what was done, how it was done, why it was done, and what it all means. It does this through presenting concrete details and terms, highlighting important details, and moving rapidly to results and recommendations. To make an informed decision about a product, readers need to know what has been found and what that means. The next vidcast will conclude the closer examination of the executive summary. If you have any questions, please talk to your TA. This has been Layern Reports, the Executive Summary, A Closer Look, Part 1, by Zachary Koppelman, in cooperation with the Purdue Online Writing Lab and prepared for the Mechanical Engineering Writing Enhancement Program.